Don't come any closer. Queen Kari's life is at stake here. When did he climb up there? Says Yurio. Chris says, you're wasting your efforts. Just hand over the queen. King Calak already knows what you're up to. Why don't you give up? What? Fine. You leave me no choice. I'm going to order you to go back to King Calak and tell him not to interfere with me. If he does, I'll kill the queen. I was planning on completing the fortress in secret and attacking Hazen by pretending to be the southern forces, but there's no need for that disguise anymore. Now, go to Haruku. Yo-Yo says, nah. Huh? We're not going to listen to bad guys. Chris says, yeah, no way. Hey, I have the queen as a hostage. Go and do as I say. Goose says, man, what a cheap fortress. There's nothing here. Apego says, let's go home. Kanta says, let's go. I'm tired after all the running. Shirla says, man, it was a waste to tie up all those soldiers. Goose's plans never work. Shut up! Huh? What? Shirla says. Goose says, man, we just found someone we don't like. Hey, Yurio! Huh? Chris says, eep! What are you guys wasting your time here for? I see. I underestimated you because I thought you were just kids, but you are actually bandits. Chris says, you think we are bandits? Yurio says, it looks like he thinks we're part of Goose's team. How dare he? Goose says, who's the guy in the turret? Looks like something's going on. I am Belart. You bandits have a lot of guts. Busting into my fortress? You must be famous. State your name. Shirla, he wants us to tell him who we are. You don't have a name. Make something up. How about the Bandit Brothers? You really don't have any imagination, do you? We are the infamous Wildcat Bandits. Don't you ever forget it. Sweet, just like that book we found. Ah, the Wildcat Bandits. A good name, Belart says. Wildcat Bandits, listen well. I have Queen Kari from Haruko as a hostage. Try anything stupid and I will kill her without hesitation. Now leave. Hey, hey, Goose says. That has nothing to do with us. We're mad because we came all this way and we can't find anything valuable. We were thinking that we could at least take the weapons and sell them, but even those are all burned up. What? You didn't set fire to the armory? Goose says, then that means... Yurio goes, huh? What? What? We didn't do anything. Did we, Chris? Chris says, that's right. I can use some chapel spells, but there aren't any fire spells, right? Hmm, that's suspicious, Goose says. Hey, don't come any closer. The Queen's life is at stake here. You listen too. You, the woman bandit. If you point your bow and arrow at me, the Queen is history. Shut up. Don't mix her in with our mission. We're after those kids. Goose says, hey kids, you're the ones who set fire to the weapons, aren't you? Yurio says, but weapons are so dangerous. Goose says, Chris says, we burn all the weapons that can be used for war. Kari says, that's a good thing. Aw, man, says Shirla. Those kids get in our way again. I'm getting tired of this. Goose says, idiot, we could have sold them for money. For money. Haha, Goose, Yurio says. If you're so mad, why don't you catch us? At that distance, you can't even use that rope you're so proud of, can you? Haha. That brat. How dare he make fun of me? All you can do from there is throw a rock at me. Hmm? Shirla says. Goose says, shut up. Chris says, and since you can't even aim, you'll miss us anyway. Brats. Goose. Shirla says, huh? Aha. Goose answered Shirla with his eyes. Belart says, hey, kids, I don't care about the weapons that you burned. Don't ignore me, though. I still have the queen. Listen, all I have to do is push her, and it's all over for her. Don't do anything strange now. Goose says, shut up! Go away! Hey, Bratz, you've really made us mad now. Why do you keep on getting in our way? Chris says, heh, complain all you want. Belart says they are ignoring me again. Goose picked up a rock. I can't take it anymore. I don't care if you're just a kid. I'm gonna get you. Go ahead, says Yurio. You can't hit me anyway. Take this. Here's my fastball. Haha, it's Belart. How'd I know? It's a hit. Why? Says Belart. Because you're a jerk. Yo-Yo says, I wonder if he's okay. He's just knocked out, Chris says. Oh my, look at that bump on his head. Yo-Yo says, Your Majesty, are you okay? Yes, I'm fine. Goose says, Yo, why don't you explain? Sure. Yo-Yo told him about Belart's plans. Kari says, Thank you for your help. Goose says, I guess it's a good idea to hand over this Belart guy over to the kings. Yeah, that's what we plan on doing, says Yurio. Chris says, oh, we forgot to give the signal. Yurio says, why don't you just scream from here? Chris says, yeah, that sounds like fun. Yurio says, huh? Uh-oh, says Goose. Oh no, says Apego. You ruined all my plans. I was going to bring chaos to this world by playing the two kings against each other, but... This is the most unfortunate development. Yo-Yo says, we won't let you do that. Yeah, says Chris. Goose says, your absent-mindedness, wrong kind of you are there, leads me to believe that there's a bigger boss behind you. Ugh, says Belart. Anyway, I'll let you go this time, but don't forget, you'll pay for this interference. We'll meet again. Oh, well, there he goes. Chris says, oh. Yurio says he's gone. Goose says he got away, but Yurio and his friends won this time around. Shirla says he won't be able to do anything in the Finthy area, at least. Goose says, hey Chris, remember the signal? Oh yeah, I forgot. Is he gonna go scream from the tower? He called it a turret. Goose says, so what's this signal about? Oh, we were supposed to give a signal once we saved the queen. Oh really? And then the two kings are supposed to come into the fortress. Oh, okay. What? Shirla says, you are not joking, are you? Nope. Crap. We're bandits, remember? We might get in trouble. Oh, yeah, huh? Maybe they'll arrest you, Yurio says. Hey, says Goose. Get them to stop. Chris says, Philly, can you hear me? We rescued the queen. Philly says, okay, I heard you. Uh-oh, says Goose. King Eneton! Chris says, it's okay now. King says, understood. I'm heading over now. Help. Are these people just hanging outside the fence? I mean, I thought they were back in the city. Goose says, why did you have to do that? Because you told me to, Goose. I know, but... Shirla says, this isn't good. We better get out of here. We're leaving empty-handed again? Let's go. Bye. Kari says, oh, wait. Goose says, what? I don't know what we would have done without you. This is a token of my appreciation. The queen gave Goose her necklace. You can sell it for money. Money! She says. Goose says, thanks. Goose, hurry up. The soldiers are coming. Yurio, Chris, don't you forget this, Goose says. See you around. Later. He's too funny. You can sell it for money. Money. Billy says, Yurio, Chris, good work. I was worried about you. Yurio says, yeah, we went through a lot. Eneton says, Calak, brother, it's good that Queen Kari is safe. I'm sorry, brother. Because I was foolish enough to listen to some vagabond. Eneton says, no, it was my fault, too. If we had stayed on better terms with each other, we would never have mistrusted each other like this. King Eneton and King Calak shook hands firmly. "I'm so glad," says Philly. Eneton says, "If it weren't for Philly and her friends, we wouldn't have been able to resolve these issues. Thank you, kids." Yo-Yo says, "I'm really glad." Chris says, "But your majesties, you can't relax yet. Belart was saying something about being back." Calak says, "Ah, I'll be careful. We'll be okay now, now that we're able to renew our bond. No matter what villain may arise, we won't be fooled again." Won't get fooled again, yeah! "I guess so," Kari says. This event made the bond between the North and South even stronger. The future of Fenty looks promising. We should be thanking Belart and the Wildcat Bandits. Eneton says, "Huh?" Calak says, "Wildcat Bandits? Who are they?" Kari says, "Oh my, you're behind the times. They're the keepers of peace for Fenty." Calak says, "Bandits?" Kari says, "No, protectors." King Eneton and King Calak shook hands firmly, confirming the brotherly bond that flows between them. Belart's plans are fooled by Yurio, Chris, and Philly, with timely help from the Wildcat Bandits. Fenty is on guard now. The North and the South promised each other that they will cooperate for the peace of their countries. Yurio and Chris returned to Haruka with King Calak and decided to continue their journey to Fulthia. King Calak says, "Thank you for all your help. We really appreciate it." Kari says, "It was enjoyable." Calak says, "It was really a good learning experience. I'll make sure that as brothers, we will work together for a better Fenty. I don't know what would have happened if you had not been here. Yo-Yo, Chris, Philly, thank you from the bottom of my heart." Chris says, "You're welcome." Yo-Yo says, "Even if another person like Belart comes around, you two should be okay." Calak says, "Of course. Our trust has been renewed. We will never be wicked. We will never be tricked that way again." Wicked. Philly says, "Your Majesty, I will help you too. I will travel to Haruka and Hazen frequently so the North and South can be better friends." "Oh, thank you. Knowing I will have your help takes some of the weight off my shoulders." "Okay, Yurio, we better get back on our journey. I wouldn't mind staying here longer, but I'm worried about Fulthia." "Yeah." Kari says, "What's happening in Fulthia?" Chris says, "Well, nothing definite has happened yet, but I just have this strange feeling." Yurio says, "We just want to make sure." "I see," says Calak. "Then I guess there was no point in asking you to stay. That's a shame. Be careful on your journey." "Yes, Your Majesty." Kari says, "Philly, what are you going to do?" "I will accompany Yurio and Chris up to the Western Road. I think my mother will be worried, so I'll say goodbye to the two of you and go home for now." "That's a good idea. Philly, come back and visit us soon." "I will. Thank you very much." Calak says, "Yurio, Chris, it looks like you still have a long journey ahead of you. Please be careful and good luck." Queen, everything new to say? "Thanks for all your help. I hope we can see the Wildcat Bandits again soon." So funny. Now they're billed as protectors. Opal the butler says, "Thank you. You are the heroes that saved Fenty from disaster." "I am a Haruku soldier, but I will work for all of Fenty from now on. I feel that small, biased minds bring people like Belart to take advantage of us." "The King of Ambush's friends are really great people, aren't they? You're young, but bold. You are awesome." Hear that? We're awesome. Frickin' awesome. "I helped build the fortress, too. It makes me mad that Belart tricked us so easily." "Good work. The roads have been reopened. I'm sorry we caused you trouble. On behalf of all the Fenty soldiers, please accept my apologies." "Good work, guys. Philly, come back and visit us soon." Belart was a bad man, wasn't he? I knew something was fishy about him. Oh, you, Mr. Backflip. You want me to do it again? Fine, fine. I'll do it as many times as you want. I don't think he can make it a full three times. Please forgive me. No one can do a handstand while wearing armor. Except you can. Oh, wait. Thought he would say something different. Okay. Anyone else say anything different? I honestly thought we were going to have a war between the North and the South. I'm glad everything is okay now. A strange traveler something. I see. I wonder if he's up to no good somewhere else. I really hate travelers like that. That strange traveler, his name is Belart. He got away, huh? Mm. It looks like King Calak and King Eneton has settled their differences. That's good. Real good. Queen Kari was at the fortress, wasn't she? I like the Queen a lot. I'm happy that she's back. Venthi is divided into the north and the south. Yeah, we know this. It's nothing new. King Hayes and King Calak are both very timid people. What did I say? The two of them make a good team. I'm glad that they worked everything out. Good, good. Same. It looks like the blockade has been lifted. Good. Now we'll have customers again. Oh yeah, let's get some rest. Bird kept cheeping all night long. Tweeting, chirping, cheeping, something like that. It was noisy. I wanted to kill it with a bow and arrow. I guess the two kings have finally decided to cooperate with each other, just as the queen wished. Anybody, did I? I talked to him, right? The soldiers who are guarding the exits to the roads have gone to tear down the fortress at Lake Rapinas. First they had to build it, and now they have to destroy it. It must be hard to be a soldier. Did I talk to him? Nothing new to say. And then finally in here? How do I get in there? I can't believe you're traveling at such a young age. Good luck. Oh, there's another entrance here. Oh yeah, we don't need the stuff. So... I'm guessing we're gonna go up this way, to Folthia. So we're gonna go out the west way. I'm gonna miss Philly though. Not cool. One-shotted. Don't you give me the fireball. How dare you. Tackle. Oh, their meters are all full for the next battle. That was a good amount of experience, wow. Agility food and a mind potion. Yeah, let's fight it. We got finishing moves to use up. Alright, Sword Fang on the Karameg. Light Cactus on the Wild Boar. Light Cactus on the... Chill out. Oh, we didn't kill it. Philly levels up, level 25. Learned La Recure just in time to leave us. How sad. We got some organic food. By the way, good mood. Rumbling from hunger. Let's give you the organic food. It's been a while since you used the earth-based attacks. Let's use Philly's magic. She's leaving us soon, apparently. So La Recure is heals a large amount of damage for all allies. We're gonna get a chance to even use it. Yo-Yo says, that's where the path that leads to Philly's house is, right? Yo-Yo, I hate to say this, but it's time to say goodbye. Yeah. Philly, take care of yourself. Thanks for all of your help. No, not at all. I'd do anything for you, Yo-Yo. Aw. Even not leave? Chris? Huh? Please don't fight too much with Yo-Yo, okay? This is a journey for just you two. Please make the most of it. Sure. I envy you, Chris. You're so lucky to be able to go on a journey with Yo-Yo. Philly? Philly, I still haven't thanked you for your help. You went all the way into the forest to lift my curse. Thank you, Philly. If it weren't for you, I'd probably still be sick at the inn in Aldos. Yo-Yo says, yeah, really? I just helped you because I wanted to. There's no need to thank me. Okay, I'll be going now. Yo-Yo, Chris, take care of yourselves. If you come back this way, be sure to stop by. Yes, we promise. We'll stop by, says Yo-Yo. I'll be looking forward to seeing you again. Goodbye. Bye. Chris says, we'll see you again. Farewell. Philly was such a nice girl, Chris says. Past tense? Yeah. I think she liked you, Yo-Yo. No kidding. Whatever gave you that idea, Chris? Yo-Yo. Yo-Yo. Yo-Yo! What? You scared me. Let's go. On to Fothia. We wasted enough time already. Hey, she's not supposed to be fighting. Why are you so mad? Philly just told us not to have fights. Chris, you're beginning to sound like Shirla. Did you say something? No, nothing. I think we're supposed to head... west. Can we go west? That's towards Philly's house, isn't it? He wants to go visit her already. West? Somewhere? Ryuno's voice says, Yo-Yo! Chris! Huh? That voice, Yo-Yo says. Isn't that the voice of Ryuno from the Gate of Aldos? Oh, there you are! Finally found you! Thank God I caught you! Ryuno, what's wrong? The great oracle told me to tell you that all of the warrior monks of Aldos were looking all over for you. I was worried that I wouldn't be able to catch up to you because of all the closures of the borders. You were held back too, huh? Yo-Yo says, the great oracle wanted to tell us something? Chris asks, any new information? Yeah, there is. Here is the message from Great Oracle Denkin. Okay. It looks like the source of the troubles around Fothia originated from Castle Rudo. We knew that already. However, there is a barrier set up in the castle, making it impossible even for Aldos to see what's going on. We understand that a man named Master Durzel, who used to be a court swordsman, is being incarcerated in Durufez. It'd probably be a good idea to meet with Master Durzel to find out what's going on at Castle Rudo before actually going there. Master Durzel, Chris says. I've heard that name somewhere. Oh, Yo-Yo says. Lodi was talking about him. Remember? He was saying something like the only person he can call Master is the court swordsman Durzel. I remember him saying something like that. Chris says, oh, that's the person Lodi was talking about? One more thing. It seems like Master Durzel has made contact with the Moonlight Witch. Really? Yo-Yo says. Yes. The Great Oracle was saying that he's probably the one who knows the most about the Moonlight Witch. We have to see him. Chris says, but he's jailed in Durufez, right? How can we see him? Yo-Yo says, maybe they'll let us see him if we ask. Incarcerated means that he's in jail, right? I wonder what he did wrong to be thrown in jail. That I do not know. Yo-Yo says, well, let's go meet this guy Durzel. Let's go to Durufez. Okay, let's go. We'll probably find out something new. Well, I must be going. You're going back already? I need to go back to Aldos to tell them that I gave the message to you, or the Great Oracle will be worried. Well, see you. Be careful. For you now, thank you, says Yurio. Goodbye, says Chris. See you. Huh. Chris says, I wonder what Durzel knows. Okay, Yurio, let's move on. Now, did I see something like that? Desert of Thirst. Ruins. Gadonel. There's Darufez. Oh, wow, we gotta go all this way. Over there. Okay. We'll start heading there next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.